Hi friends, welcome to Study Hall, a web series made by the Figma for Education team. My name is Miggy. I'm a designer advocate for education here at Figma. I work with educators and students on getting the most out of Figma and FigJam for their classroom. Today we're going to be talking about upgrading education teams, creating education teams, and inviting students to those education teams so you can collaborate and work together in the same space. Let's go. Here I am in Figma. This is figma.com, where you can go and you can sign up for an account. Once you sign up for an account, you can register and get verified for your education team. Once you've been verified for your education team, you can then go back to Figma. Now, when you come back to Figma, you will see a few things. First off, you'll see upgrade plan from limited design files and teams. By verifying, it doesn't automatically create a education team for you. You need to do so manually. So I'm going to go ahead and hit upgrade. Here you'll see professional and it says free for students and educators. Let's go ahead and upgrade to professional. And here I'm going to click upgrade. I'm going to choose that this is designated as an education team. And now I'm able to review and complete my upgrade. And you'll see that this is now provided at no cost for me. So I can actually go back to my team and you'll see now that this is labeled as an education team. Let me zoom that in for you. So this is now an education team for education users only. At this point, you can now invite students to collaborate with you on this team. But let's first show you how to create a new team. So let's say you have multiple classes. I'm gonna go ahead and choose create new team. Here is my team name. I'm gonna say that this is my new class, you know, UX 101. I'm gonna go ahead and create that team. And here it's going to ask for my collaborators. I can just skip that. And here I'm going to choose my team plan. You'll notice the education option over here at the right. And this will only show up if you're verified. So now I can complete that upgrade and you will now see my UX 101 team. This team will be your space to create projects where you can create new design files. So I can create a new FigJam file. I can create a new design in this place. And what we're going to do next is invite our students to join us with these teams. So what I'm going to do is with this team right here, I'm going to head on over to invite members, and here you'll see an invite link, and I can choose whether or not to allow those individuals clicking that link to view or edit the team. I'm going to go ahead and give them edit access, and I can copy that link. So with this link, I can now share it to my LMS and or with my students to allow them to join my team. You'll see here there's a little setting where I can reset those invite links or turn them off if I feel that that link has been abused or it's beyond the date that I wanted them to join. So you can also invite them by email, but I highly recommend creating and copying these links and sharing it with them. Let's show you what the experience will look like for your students. So I'm going to copy that link. And I'm going to head on over to this other browser. So I'm going to paste that link to this browser. And you'll notice that it's immediately going to ask me to sign in. If your students don't have an account, they can create a new one right now. Let's create a new one. M Cardona. Let's just say +100@org.figma.com. That's just a test email that I have. And let me just create a password. So I'm going to create an account. It's then going to ask your student a little bit about themselves. So I'll just say, student Miggy, what kind of work do I do? You know, I'm in design and I will be teaching or taking a class. So as a student, I will be taking a class. So I'm going to join that mailing list and create an account. So what's going to happen next is I'm going to be prompted to verify my email. So off screen right now, I am verifying the email. I'm going to go ahead, copy that link address and paste it right here. So I'm going to verify that account. So you can see that my email has been verified, and now I'm going to join UX 101 with my student Miggy account. So there it is. I have now joined, and you'll see from the student's perspective, they're going to be prompted to validate for education. So it says I only have 7 days left to verify that I'm a student or educator. I'm going to go ahead as a student. I'm going to verify that status, and I'm going to verify as a student. You know, I'll say you know, because Teach told me so. And you'll see that the school's name and the primary field of study has been carried over from the professor account, so they need not worry about filling that out. If your school is not listed, feel free to say school not listed and write in your school. My expected graduation date, let's say as a student, I'm going to graduate in 2026. I agreed by those terms. I hit submit, and then I will be brought back to this team. And you'll see that as a student, the first team on my account is going to be the team that the professor that you invited me to. So I have access to this team, and then I can now collaborate on this team. So as the professor, so here I am in my professor mode, I can create new projects. So I could call this lessons. I'm going to create that project. And in this project, I can add in new files. So let's go ahead. I'm going to go to figma.com/community. And as part of the community, I'm going to type in, let's say, classroom activity. And I have here a couple of different examples. So let's say I have this classroom brainstorming activity. And I like that template. I'm going to go ahead and duplicate that. So now this template, I'm going to put it in that classroom. So here I can move it to a project. And let's say I'm going to move it to those lessons, right? So this has now been moved to my lessons. And if I go back, let's go back to my Figma files, you will see that here in my lessons, I have this folder. So when I go inside here, I can go and into the share, and I can see, you know, who has access. So anybody with the link can view, but everyone at UX 101 can access this file. As a student, right, I can go into that lessons folder and I can see that space, and I can see that the professor is already in there. I can open up that file and I'm good to go. So I'm able to hop right into this file and collaborate with my teacher, and I can even, you know, wave to them. So I'm gonna hold down the H key and wave to the professor. How cool is that? Hopefully you found this helpful. Thanks for watching, and be on the lookout for more Study Hall videos. If you have any questions, feel free to email education@figma.com. Thank you and have a great day.